tubers is a big kid here, Archer's friend, on the tube, and bigkidreviews.com and many more. Today, I want to show you a little accessory that's not very expensive that you can get for your AR. This happens to be my pink furniture Century Arms C39, made in the USA completely, with a milled receiver. And I don't mind the pink for the money I saved on it. But anyway, old tired eyes and whatnot. The sight, front sight on there is the typical, your black. And it's a very long threaded setup here. But the aftermarket people have come up with a sight assortment, different colors. You got this lime green, another orange, this one that's kind of translucent, that might would pick up light pretty good. And this one's a solid color, kind of a red or orange, depending on your eyesight. And then it has a black solid one that would go. Why you'd replace a steel one with a plastic one, I don't know, but that's not my purpose in life. And then it has this kind of a fluorescent one that I chose. It picks up light really good in the sun. And when I'm looking into the shade with a black one, I can't see it. So I went and put that in there. And it makes a big difference for me on seeing. And turned out I thought I had an adjustment tool for that thing, and I didn't, so I ended up getting one of those too. And I've got a one of these deals here for the regular AKs where you adjust the front sight by pushing it back, you know, sideways. I didn't really need to do any of that. Mine, this Century was jam up right ready to go. I didn't even adjust the front sight. It was right spot on for what I needed. But before you start doing all that, you need to, if your gun is already sighted, you need to come across here and measure the distance from this shade down to the top of that sight with a good set of calipers or a set of calipers that's got this depth gauge on there. And you just simply set this thing up on the top like this, and slide it down till it touches the tip of your sight, and see what it's recording, and then write it down, because when time you get through, you may forget about it and those digital ones go off. If you use the analog, it may change the adjustment, picking it up, moving it around. So you really do need some kind of a good calipers. I've checked this inexpensive one from Harbor Freight against my Brown and Sharp one, and it's the analog on the Brown and Sharp, and it's just as good. Then I have another analog one just for an extra spare, and it all agrees. So probably as close as you're going to get it. But you need to do that. You need to check from the top of this down to the tip of that before you start screwing with it. And on mine, it's got right-hand thread, so lefty-loosey, righty-tighty, left, pull it all the way out, and then screw it in. You got to be careful, because the way they've done this is, as well as the original factory one, let me pick that one up, as you can try to get it where it's, you can see it. See, it's got a slot in there, and so that's what gives you your strength, or not your strength, but your snugness to keep it from coming undone. So it's spread. So it's a little booger bear to get started. You got to hold down pressure on it and turn it very gently, or it'll cross thread. And the plastic ones are even pretty similar, except that it's not split all the way, and so it gives you a little bit over advantage over this steel one that is split all the way. The plastic ones, you still got to be careful that they'll go in there and cross thread. But if you just take your time and do it, you know, real slow, and if it's obviously tilted, you might, you know, go ahead and take it back loose and try to straighten it up. But it'll eventually go. Even my old clumsy arthritic hands and terrible eyesight, I got mine in there. And it may be of some advantage to turn this a little 90 degrees from the way I've got it. I don't know, this turns out to be pretty close to where it was when I measured it. I may have to fine tune it when I shoot it, I don't know. But it also gives you that bigger spot down there to catch light. And if you get sunlight shining on that booger, boy, it shines like a bright penny. So you get one, two, three, four, five, counting the one that's in my gun, and this is the standard one on this set. And then if you don't have one of these adjustment tools, it's got the little C deal to move the front sight if yours has to have that. But this tool up here is you set that on top of the sight and then screw this. You might unscrew it all the way or screw it in, depending on what you want to do. Then you can hold on this and just turn on the T-handle there. So three things that I would really recommend before you start this: to get you a caliper that has a depth gauge. Be sure it's got a depth gauge. Almost all of them worth anything at all will have that. If they don't have a depth gauge, then, you know, it's not going to do you any good. Adjuster tool, and then the sights replacement. So I'll put links down in the description of a place to get those. It's pretty easy to come across, and as well as some calipers. But just thought I'd take a little time to show you that. And boy, inside the shop in the shade, you can see how well that shows up versus if this black one was here. That's what you'd be looking at, black on black against black and whatnot. And I've put a little night glow paint on my rear sight to kind of help me out differentiate the colors. If it's black, 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 it's a real booger bear for me. But I kind of like this plastic thing, and I'm going to leave this protection here so it won't be anything beaten on that. And plus, you got something to measure from. All right, well, that's all I got for today. And appreciate you watching, and appreciate you subscribing, and like, a share, and thumbs up, always appreciated. Help everybody out on the tube, make a comment or two. You can even take a jab at me for the pink gun, but that's all right. I got a pink holster for my carry gun too, so my theory is, and I don't know if you can even see it, but over there on the rack of my UTV, I got a pink furniture Daisy Red Rider that's my constant companion. And my theory on that's, nobody's going to fool with a old fat man with pink gun. So that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. See you on the next video. Appreciate you. Bye now.